Hare Krishna, so we welcome you again. Let's go to the chapter 5. Karma Yoga, action in Krishna consciousness, or in Sanskrit it is said Karma Sannyasa Yoga. So the acronym for this chapter was Dates. Vedi stands for doubt re-clarified, A for act in Karma Yoga, T for three doers, E for equal vision, and S for steps from Karma Yoga to Ashtanga Yoga. So this is your high level, you know, division of the chapter. So the first topic, doubt re-clarified. Now we have written doubt re-clarified. Re-clarified means again. So this is the second time Arjuna is asking the question, is karma is superior or sannyas is superior? Is performing one's duty is superior or renouncing one's action is superior? Yes. Okay. I'll come back to that. So Aman is saying the chapter name is Karma Sannyas Yoga, so both are mixed together. And Krishna is saying through the chapter, by performing a karma, by performing one's prescribed duties and being detached from the results is actually sannyas. And that's what he's teaching again and again. So coming back to this little reflection, Arjuna is still persisting with the same doubt. Should I fight or not fight? Although Krishna in the previous chapters have very clearly told Arjuna, Arjuna, pick up your weapon and fight. So how come Arjuna is not able to understand that? We saw verses just like third chapter, 30th verse, Mai Sarvani Karmani. You know, Krishna says, do everything for me. You should engage in this duty of fighting. This is, you know, very fortunate soul gets it. So why Arjuna is still persisting with the doubt? Something to reflect upon in our life also. Something to what we are very much attached to. It is not very easy. For example, mentally, if we are attached to a certain thought process, it is not very easy to change that thought process. Arjuna, by default, is convinced that he should not fight. That's what he gave several reasons. And from one perspective, they were correct. And he gave all bona fide reasons for not fighting. And after that, because he was not able to know what to do for himself, he says, Shishya Seham Sadhi Mam Tvam Prapanna, my dear Lord, I surrender unto you. Yet after he surrendered, when Krishna clearly told him, Arjuna, you should fight, yet Arjuna is not able to get that idea. He's again asking Krishna, my dear Lord, his work is superior or renunciation is superior? Just imagine if Krishna tells Arjuna at the battlefield right now, Arjuna, you are a great warrior, you know, you are a great bowman. Pick your bow and arrow and shoot an arrow so that there could be a rainfall right now. You know, he had all that potential. Just like at the end when Bhishma had succumbed to injuries when he was on the deathbed, then Bhishma told Arjuna, Arjuna, I am very thirsty. And Arjuna took his bow and arrow, shot an arrow in the ground, and the Ganges came out. So Arjuna had that all potential. If Krishna would have asked Arjuna right now at this stage, when this conversation is going on, Arjuna, pick your bow and arrow. It's too dry. It's too hot. Please make some rainfall. What do you think Arjuna would have done? He would have done that immediately? Yes? Well, he could have done that immediately, but when Krishna is saying, Arjuna, fight, why is he not able to do that? See, so that's what, go back deep in your own consciousness. External, Krishna, you know, Shishya Siham Sadhimam Tvam Prapanna. Arjuna says, I surrender. What is the meaning of surrender actually? Sharanagati, which Krishna demands at the end of Bhagavad Gita, Sarva Dharman Parityaja Mam Ekam Sharanam Vraja. It's not that easy to surrender. You know, there is something called as external, something called as internal. External things are easy to change and adapt to. Just like, you know, putting on the, you know, Vaishnava attire, you know, other things, taking to the food habits and so forth. But to change one's thinking, to change one's thought process, to change one's, you know, convictions about life, the things on which he has faith or she has faith, is very difficult. Because Arjuna was convinced, nah, I should not fight. And he gave five reasons. And Krishna systematically, one by one, he argued against those reasons. And he proved Arjuna why they are not correct. It is interesting, yet Arjuna asked, my dear Lord, in other words, he's saying, are you sure karma is superior than renunciation? Isn't that? Have you done that? Think about it, like, you know, when you're having, let's say you're having a discussion with a superior, where you're in some consultation, and superior is telling you to take option B. However, you think option A is better. You think option A is better, I should take option A. But you decided to consult with the senior. And when you consult with the senior says, no, take option B. So what do we ask? Are you really sure option A is the best option? Is that something like that is coming out, you know, in this question of what Arjuna is saying? And that's what I like about this conversation between Arjuna and Krishna. You know, these small nuances, incidents between this conversation gives us this experience that this was a living conversation between two individuals. It is not a mythology or a fiction, or not some philosophical writing. We all have experienced, pretty sure. I mean, if you go back in your childhood days, in some dealings with our parents, you know, we wanted an ice cream and mother said, no, have gulab jamun, it's cold, it's not good. And you know how adamant we go, no, I want ice cream only. Mother says, but it's not good, take gulab jamun. Are you sure? In winter season, I have heard it doesn't cause us any problem. But allopathy doctor says, eat ice cream 365 days a year. You know, we come up with those reasons. Like that is going on with Arjuna here. So the point of surrender, generally we take it very lightly. To surrender, to make progress in the path of bhakti yoga, is a lifelong commitment. It needs enough determination. Because what is this process? The process teaches us is to follow. Krishna is demanding Arjuna, right? Sarva dharman pariteja, follow me. So which means we have to give up the faith on my thinking. We have to replace that faith on my thinking by putting faith on Guru, Sadhu and Krishna. And that's the journey. That's our journey of life. Where we begin with having a strong faith in my own opinions, my own thinking, and we have to replace, gradually purify ourselves. This whole process of purification which is mentioned is to purify ourselves, to develop a faith, a strong, unflinching faith in Guru, Sadhu, Shastra. And who could be a better example than Srila Prabhupada? His spiritual master, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, asked Srila Prabhupada, you are an educated young man, you know English, you should preach the message of Bhagavad Gita in English everywhere. If you get an opportunity, you should travel abroad and share this message of Bhagavad Gita. When Srila Prabhupada, he was just hardly 21 or 22 year old, he couldn't believe, how can I do this? I'm a family man. How can I follow this instruction? Yet Srila Prabhupada, in his capacity, he tried to do it. Because Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur told him, if you have money, print some books, Krishna conscious literature, and distribute it. And Prabhupada tried to do it at his best. And then later on, when he was 50 years plus, then he was getting the vision where Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur was telling him, take sannyas. Now you have to go out and preach. And Srila Prabhupada, then as Abhay Charande, had never ever thought of taking sannyas. And he's like, no, this is a dream. It cannot be a factual thing. And eventually circumstances turned on and so forth that Srila Prabhupada understood, this is what my spiritual master wants. And see, simply, just Srila Prabhupada's following, having that 100% faith in Guru's instruction, look what wonderful, incredible thing. I mean, this, you can say it as a pastime just to teach, if we draw a lesson from Srila Prabhupada's life. Just by sticking to the instruction of his spiritual master, can you imagine a 70-year-old man who has never traveled abroad, who does not have a penny, who does not have a friend, who does not know anything about the culture and the lifestyle? He knows that they are yavanas, they are cow flesh eaters and meat eaters. And these are not the people who are going to take to Krishna consciousness. Can you imagine how much of a mind will give reasons not to go? I'm an old man. I'm 70-year-old man. And that too, Srila Prabhupada had to go on a cargo ship. How can I travel on a cargo ship? I've never sailed on the ocean. A 70-year-old man sailing on an ocean is a life-threatening. And Prabhupada got two heart attacks. Can you imagine what surrender means through this example a little bit? How, you know, Prabhupada had to, if in case he had those doubts, but he didn't have. But I'm just saying, if you and I would be at that place, how many doubts would be running through our head? Prabhuji, family ka kya? Chalo, family side mein hua. Theek hai, sanyas ho gaya. Prabhuji, mera kya? मैं 70 साल का वृद्ध व्यक्ति आप ऐसे देश में भेज रहे हैं जहां मुझे किसी चीज का कुछ पता नहीं है. एंड दैट इज व्हाट द जर्नी फेथ. वी ऑल बिगिन अवर जर्नी विद द फेथ इन आई द माइंड दैट वी जनरली थिंक ऑफ. एंड द होल जर्नी टेक्स अस टू हैविंग यू नो 100% फेथ इन गुरु साधु शास्त्र. इफ माई गुरु हैव सेड इट दैट इंस्ट्रक्शन कम्स विद एन एम्पावरमेंट एंड इट विल हैपन ट्रू. And that's how what happened with Srila Prabhupada. And that's how at the end of Bhagavad Gita, when Krishna asked Arjuna, Arjuna, so you decide what you want to do. Whatever I had to say, I have spoken to you. And Arjuna said, my dear Lord, I have understood everything. I'll follow your order. And look, Arjuna's life was glorious. So glorious that more than 5,000 years ago, people are still talking about Arjuna and Krishna. And if you look back into the history, Duryodhana also had an opportunity. Yes? When both Arjuna and Duryodhana had gone to meet Lord Shri Krishna, and Krishna said, you can ask for two things. You can ask for me, but I'm not going to fight, or you can ask for my whole army, Narayani Sevana. You decide. Arjun chose to go with a single man, whom we call as Bhagawan, Lord Shri Krishna. He decided to go with the one man who is not going to even fight against the whole army. Does it take faith or not? There is no logic here. Are you seeing? So when it comes to spiritual life, or when it comes to life in this world, logic doesn't work, because our logic is limited by our limited understanding of this world. So when we put our logic into the situation and try to manipulate, it doesn't work out. Arjuna could have sat there and could have thought, you know, Duryodhana has 12 Akshani Sena, we have only 7 Akshani Sena. Now if we take Narayani Sena, we'll reach up to 10 Akshani Sena. We are just less by 2. So we are matching with it. But if I take Krishna, what do I get? I'm still less by 5 Akshani Sena. He could have said, just give me some time, huh? Let us think and come back. And he could have done all mathematics, all calculation, permutation, future planning, all that. And he would have said, oh, my logic says, Krishna, you're not going to fight anyways. What's the use? I should go with Akshani Sena. Yes. And for that reason, Duryodhana was very pleased, was very happy. Duryodhana was thinking, cha, this poor Arjuna is so foolish. And because Arjuna chose Krishna, today, even after 5,000 years ago, we speak about Arjuna, not Duryodhana. Because Duryodhana chose against Krishna, so Duryodhana is not glorified. Duryodhana is not talked about. Who is talked about? Arjuna. Why? Because he accepted Krishna. So just by accepting Krishna, Arjuna became eternal. For all the time to come, Arjuna and Krishna are to be known and would be known together. Similarly, we can become eternal if we accept Krishna. And that's the promise Krishna gives in 4th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, right? 4.9. Janma karma chame divyam evam yoveti tattvatah tyaktva deham punarjanma naiti mameti sarjana. One who understands the transcendental nature of my birth, of my appearance, of my pastimes and activities after leaving this world, he does not come back to this world. Where he goes to the world of eternity. That's the idea about it. And that was a little thought on it, why Arjuna is still asking. And don't worry, Arjuna will again ask it. He's going to again ask that. He's still not convinced. And accepted, if you remember in the very first session of Bhagavad Gita, I had said, Bhagavad Gita is a journey of dharma. Because it begins with dha. Dhritarashtra uvacha. Syllable dha, and it ends with the syllable ma. And this whole journey of Bhagavad Gita is a journey of dharma. And what is the journey of dharma? Is moving on from faith on one's own abilities, intellect, to having a faith in the mercy of Guru, Sadhu and Shastras.